Hi guys, welcome to a video. It's quite late. I haven't done a model video in a while, but it's nice to just catch up a bit. It's not going to be a super long video because of the time and how I feel, but I want to catch up with you guys with a model railway video and some updates to the railway. And there's a variety of a few other bits along the way with this video. That the Christmas Eve video is going to be super well. I'm going to pre-make it for Christmas Eve, which is just day before Christmas Eve, just because Christmas Day is going to be an utter nightmare. Just don't have a free time most of this year with things going on. So today it's just going to be a running day with Nature's Tease, which means people would probably come the same. Now, Nature's Tease are one of the classics, iconic beauties of the British railway industry, especially for the 1970s, well into the year 2000s. But, you know, it's still an iconic set from many Nature's Tease enthusiasts, not just myself, but others around the society of the HSTs. There's plenty of them around, so if you're looking forward to see all these tonight running between First Great Western, East Midlands, East Coast, British Rolling City Set, Castle Set, Junior, and of course First Great Western. So we're going to get them all running tonight. Obviously it is mainly going to be for tonight, it's going to be all the HSTs, which means for those who don't want to see HSTs and they want to see something different to run around this layout, you won't check on another video I have made on steam locomotives earlier this year, which means plenty of YouTubers or train contents people like Sam's Trains, that 123, IT82, which he doesn't make content, but there's still his videos up on the platform. Sam's Trains is still pretty good. I've never gotten anything wrong with his videos, and I had nothing against his content. There's quite a few YouTubers out there. I mean, I'm probably one of the newest YouTubers out there, but I'm not the newest. That's for sure. But yeah, been on YouTube for a long time. Right, last one of the evening for running the 43s. When am I gonna get the carriages for the First Great Western set? Gosh, I gotta get them ordered. Still got no one to order for East Coast, and probably a couple of the rest of the things I own. So if you just bear with me just for a few minutes while I'm organizing, taking the jumper off and organizing the track. Yes, if you might hear my voice, I am not great. Excuse me. I am full of cold. And yes, I know it doesn't sound nice, but it's not the worst, that's for sure. I have had things worse than having a standing cold like this. It's just not nice at all, but at the same time, it's not the worst thing. Why am I filming through my phone and not the camcorder? Well, I thought it might be a change and it'd be nicer to film somewhere different than just the camcorder all the time. Some people might prefer seeing me filming from the camcorder quite regularly because that's what you're used to seeing on me. But in the end, it's not really a big deal. I'm just organising some updates to the railway. And yes, the railway is still under tidying investigation because it hasn't tidied in quite a while. But I'm trying my best to get it organised as soon as I can. Just need to organise it. Right, okay, track is good to go. I've just got to clip the wires back in down there. And we'll go for whatever train I pick for this evening. I'm not making it a super long video, but half an hour might be a good time to end it off. I don't think I actually got to the point of half an hour yet. 6 minutes in. It'll be a half an hour to 40 minute video and that'll be it. But it'll give me plenty of time to get some trains running. And I'll give you plenty of shots of different point of perspectives, so to speak, for the trains to run. Yes, I'm going to be not doing videos one on my own like this, but I want to do it one. Well, yeah, I want to do it today and then hopefully on Saturday as well to do a Motherwell video for you this week, so that way I can sort of span it out a bit instead of just leaving it to just the mainline trains or the places I go on the real trains. I just don't want to leave it just to that, but I just don't have all free time to do everything that I want to do, so that's why I do run out of time very quickly during my filming. I run out of time to do everything else when I'm doing videos on the main line or doing photography with the trains and landscape videos, landscape photos as well. It's just too much to consider when it comes to trying to fit everything in on a railway video. A model of a video is just not possible to get everything put into one day. You need to have it over several days to connect the units. Well, you need several days just to make the video and then get it uploaded the next day. It takes me, generally when I make a model of a video, it takes me a couple of hours. If I'm doing it through the camcorder, it will take me 2 to 3 hours for just putting it up, because once it's up it takes forever to get it edited and uploaded, if it needs that at all. If it's a raw video, you don't need to worry about that, which means it leaves you to not survive so much. But if you're using a camcorder, you have to edit some bits out. But yeah, it's a complicated system. As a YouTuber, it doesn't come very easily. Looking connection, there's no lights on both ends, but I've seen nothing. Just gonna move that out of the way. I haven't seen any power problems though. Why is she not running? I want to know why she's not running. She was running fine yesterday when I had her running. Oh, I see. that means the light's not going to come on because they're not connected from one section. There's got to be a connection issue around here somewhere. But I'm not seeing it. I'm going to put on my training car and see any power supply issue. It's not there. It's to do with the controller. I think it's to do with the controller directly. It's the cables leading up to them. I don't have the connections properly. I need to thin those wires out to connect to them. That one is going the correct way, and that one should be connecting to the other one. Right, that is on. Powers should be fine. Now she's on. She's a little stiff, but that'd be surprising. She's one of the few who actually run during my layout. She is a connector train. Straight into the controller is doing my head in. I'm just gonna change it over just for tonight. I just don't wanna start with it. Oh, I see. Perfect. And then need to be so that goes in there. That one goes in there, I think. One good thing about my experience with wiring, it's pretty good. I want to connect it and make sure everything is connected up well. That's the thing. So if they're not connected, I'm not going to run. Okay, I know what it means. It means I've got to freaking deal with the smoking controller. The one that actually does work with this controller is this one. And I've got to fight for this damn thing. You may ask why, but for myself, this controller is a nightmare. I could do again a couple of new ones of these, the Gage Master Combis, instead of five of this old one. Just trying to get myself in there. Come on. And put it down once the other one was in. AC electrics. Doesn't have to have model trains over it, but do I have another controller to hand if I need it? Yes, I do, if I need it. There we go. I told you it's a fiddle. Why would it do that? Right, I'm gonna let everyone around. Hopefully the track will be behave itself in time I've got it for filming. What? Shouldn't really do anything. Well, decoupled. Just trying to bend the coupler at the back of the car so set, because how it is to go on when they're travelling. So, you guys will see the video and think to yourself, what if I made the video? That would be pretty cool. But, yeah, the controller is a pain in the butt at times. I'm not going to go all forwards, but I want to sort of go around at a speed that the unit itself is happy with. I might have to have a speaking video for you because this video might turn out to be a little bit frustrating for me. This controller does not want to play ball with me tonight. And yeah, I do need to get a couple of new Gage Master Combis. This is lying on the old one, which is showing its age. I mean, it doesn't burn out like the other one does, which is why I use the older one online too. So, all I'm going to do is move away from this area with the power. And Why is she so noisy? Good question. She knows that pretty well. For the most part. And as you can see, she's running fine. Until she falls apart from the train. But yeah, she is... Well, she's going to be running that way. So I'm going to send the controller that way very shortly, but... I'm going to get you guys in a position where you guys can see it. It moving before I'm going up to stand on the couches. Just excuse my hand out of the way. Just gonna try my best to keep my things out of the way too. I'm gonna try to get this angle for you. So bear with me while I'm doing this. I will lean over and grab the controller. Because, you know, it's just the easier thing to do. Track does play out sometimes, but mainly because it's, I don't know the main reason, but I know for certain it's for one of the reasons that they have. Here she comes again. This time she should have come out with comfort. I wonder to run a happy, really. I'm gonna change this real quick. Well, she came round to me, that's unusual. Most of the trains would just pick up a fight with me. But 43s do not do that to me. Which is nice. Just trying to catch the clip right, I'm just gonna connect them weirdly. If they go through now, do the train. Without your train, I said that before. She's over the back there, and she's got red lights, but... I think mine has changed the straight piece in it. I think the straight piece on this end is just not working properly. And it's changing. Which is good for you. Well, it's on, but I could have been just turned on again. I'm gonna have to get over again to the back in. Give you guys a couple of shots of this train and then get my other two out, well, so four, five in total. I don't send a get many angles of this train very often. I'm in one direction now. And if I had it that way, but the train's got to be pointing this way. I'm going to do it in a way that catches the train. Yeah, then it tips slightly. You guys can see the trains, hopefully. But we'll get a couple shots passing here. The light level is pretty dim. I can't control what the light level is doing because it's night time. There we go. Keep a little slow along it. I think for now we're going to leave us here. We're going to move over to the next train. The next one I'm going to pick out is the First Great Western HST, which is my newest one in the collection, most newest. I've got three, is it three this year? I can't remember. These choice I got this year, definitely. I got also East Midlands and East Coast and the First Great Western, so there's three in total I picked up this year. So we've got First Great Western on the back and First Great Western Park on the front. I'm just going to be pulling this train today. Just going to get wheels on and pick it up to our carriages. There we go. It's a lot faster. Oops. I mean, she's going so far. I mean, she is like a grumpy car. Oh, it's so down to now. Nah, travel a train. So we're gonna have to slow it down a bit. I think she is so quick. That's mental. I mean, if a train could move that fast, wow, that would be insane. I mean, it's not saying that it's possible, because it probably is, but I wouldn't recommend it to test the train to go that fast. Even if it is a real passenger train on the main line between London and Birmingham New Street area, there's a runway point up in the south of the UK of the railway industry. There's a part of the railway up there where some trains, they allow their trains to go fast as possible to keep up with the trafficking they have on the railway up there. But here she is. She's now, she's just here with her train. I'm gonna keep her. I just want you guys to see it before I change them over. And I'm gonna change these specs around. I slowed her down for a reason. She's just too fast for the slightly incorrect carriages. But I think during the end of the time when they had the swap replacement from the GWR, well, the Great Western, so it's this locomotives, they replaced them with the castle sets. So I'd imagine in the time they had to change them, because they were changing out, I think, to GWR was probably a last minute choice, I would imagine, for them. But, you know, it's not the end of the world, that's for sure. I'm going to get to the other trains in a minute, to locomotives. She has run in, this new one. She is running perfectly well. So we're going to get on to the next train before I lose out the time, because we've done 33 minutes. Well, we have done a bit. Right, Intercity, I will guess next. The Intercity. You know, the iconic British Rail Intercity set from the 1970s to the modern day, or fairly modern day, shall I say. I think they got taken out of service in the 1970s, and they got taken off the railway use, I think, by, is it 1998 or was it 1999? I can't remember. It's been a while since I looked at things like that. Missing something, but I'm not quite sure what. There we go. Got that one out. I think that's all done. Oh, City is not up next. Just gonna get a front end on and then a back end. And then connect the train. I'm gonna open her up a bit, because she's a high speed train after all. She deserves to go fast. Oh, I always get excited when I get an HSC about. I mean, it's my passionate train after all, and it's my pride of passion train and my whole collection. That's why I look after them, because I know exactly why they're trying to find the future and working train in the street. I'll probably come home. I was working with Model Rail one day in the future, just to work with the Model Railway stuff as well. And just, I don't know, in the future I don't think I would probably change my perspective of the railway industry at all, but I think my photography and my Model Railway stuff is probably going to be mine. So, yeah, it's, I know a lot of people are saying about the other locomotives or the HSCs, how many do I own in total? I own 5, I think, in my house collection at the moment. The next one we're going to look at running in a minute is going to be the East Midlands set, and then East Coast, I think, to end the run off. So yeah, we'll just get a few more shots of her, and then we'll probably call it there at the East Coast one. Because obviously, everything knows about the trains. I'm just gonna grab this Midlands train HSC set. And we're just gonna go about the East Coast. There we go. She's in the line of reach, which is good. So, I think we're going to call it here the Intercity. These are Intercity in VR blue and yellow livery. Classic VR livery days. I think a lot of us miss the older liveries of the HST to the newer ones, the castles. If you are the HST, you're just in one that for. I mean, she's green, but it's alright. I will say the reason why it's alright, have it in my colour, because well, it's not a bad colour, however it is very dark livery. It's not the nicest livery for you to see. It's not like, you know, you're going back from the 1970s to the 1980s to 1999 to the year 2000. All those points of time between those 4 or 6 generations of HSTs will be the hybrid trains. At a maximum top speed of 148 miles per hour on the East Coast Railways, and she did do it. She did it. I mean, it's just to show the power and strength of these. I've kind of looked at these hybrid trains, what they're further doing. They cut down journey times of the original trains could never do. That's 6.5 hours, or 8.5 hours with steam engines. And the HSTs had diesel hybrid engine they had on both ends. They had maybe a bit faster, in less 4.5 hours. Or was it 3.5 hours or something in thousand of journey wise? And they could do it in very efficiently because of the way they move. I mean, these are British diesel hybrid sets from the 1970s. They're not like YTs or Javelins or Logic Series. 804s, even the wave ones that you see in other parts of the country, as you call that. The third rail system, that is something that's really different. But we are, as a nation, as British people, we've seen a lot of British trains over the years, not seen the international ones like Canada-based DB cargo sets, which are common in the UK now. They have been for a while, but GBRF, I think they are British, I think. I'm not 100% sure, but I'm pretty sure they are British. Right, there you go, just put in the Buffy car. They're two clicked on, these two going. And we've just got Junior and East Coast next, and then we're done for the evening. If you hear a weird noise from the East Midland one, don't worry, it's not anything, it's like it's going to blow up or anything, it's just the fans are spinning on this particular model, while the rear lights are on, but I haven't got the front end of this particular she needs to connect on as well. It's her train after all. Here she comes, these movements. She's not going fast. I'm not going to say I go fast, but she'll fall off. But it's ground level, it's not going to fall off and break anything because it'll just tip on itself and it'll just lay flat onto the board, which is not so bad. But yeah, it's the East Midlands HST running around on the lap now. I'm going to show you around. I'm going to try to keep my hands out of the way because my hands are right in the way. There we go. It's a really important thing. You can't speed up a bit, aren't you? I noticed that. She's going fast. I haven't got any of the proper going for her. Get a couple more shots of power and then we'll switch over to the family. With our livery. You can see the Perfect Western is there. I don't think it's taken. But we're gonna just we're gonna stop that, I think. Right, let's get her off the track. She's flying around like a crazy man. But yeah, I will do a proper running session for you guys with all these sets, so you see, I might be. I might be ill, but it's not going to stop me to enjoy trains, that's for certain. East Midlands are up next. Oh, East Coast is up next. Where's her carriage? I am not seeing her carriage anywhere. It's a silver one. I've seen it though. Genie House over there. Right. bear with me. I've got East Coast and then GNR and we're done. So it'll be alright because it shouldn't be take too much longer. GNR is the last one on the list for this evening, which is good. And we'll just get the power going. I'm filming on the main line on Thursday, will be in well, and assuming I'm actually well enough to do it. I'm hoping so. It's now looking a little bit strange because the East Coast put in one carriage and not two, but I will get another carriage for soon. But she'll run around as fast as she can because she is the East Coast one. I'm not going to touch it too much. Just want to speed it up a little bit, but not much. I'm going to get some close-up shots of her. We'll make this one quick because we've got Junior to end off with. Guys, I think that's gonna be maybe the end of the video. I think maybe 9 o'clock when I'm gonna get the last train on. This video will really take longer, especially running the 43 around here. Not that simple. But I'm gonna bring up. And we'll get the last train to run. We'll call it a day. Right, East Coast is done. We've got GNR up next, the oldest one from 2022. Yep, you heard it right. She is the oldest one I own in my collection. She is the oldest. I don't know why. She was the first one I ever got. I like the midnight blue on this one. And the red doors, they're just fantastic. I always try to get every livery of the Heat Estate as possible. There's still a few I haven't got. I haven't got Grand Central yet, and I haven't got the Network Rail one, I haven't got Pullman, I haven't got the cross country sets. There's a few I haven't owned as yet. I'm hoping over time to own a few more, because I still haven't owned the Intercity Swallow set either. But I'm hoping that can all change over time. stunning to see it. Where's the captain gone? You can kind of see actually, it's hidden underneath the actual connection. It's right there. There we go. Oh well. Come on. Don't just do well because I got. I understand that one. Here you go. Run faster if she wants to, but she needs to grab a train. She kind of leave a train behind. Okay, I think I'm going to have to call it here, even though I want to get the junior running. Probably pass you on the camera, I just don't have time tonight. It's actually just 1 minute before 9 o'clock p.m. because I've got medication to take. Oh. So I'm going to try to get junior working for you for another video on Saturday instead of tonight. I don't have time tonight to fill with it. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, give it a like, comment and subscribe to the channel, and I'm appreciating all you guys' support and love to my content recently. I noticed some of my videos are just very popular at the moment, which is pretty nice. I haven't seen it that probably in a long time. We have 1k viewers on the shorts, and that's pretty incredible. But I am just going to pack things away now and just end off and see you guys. Which, yeah. We'll come back to making another video on the railway when I got more carriages for the trains. We'll make a proper video on it Christmas Eve with First Great Western carriages. Would be pretty nice. Right, we've got GNR. Right, that one's the East Midlands, which we don't need to do right now. Get that one sorted. There we go. And then Intercity. With the cars set 43, which is Cardiff Castle 43187, and then we've got the Bridge Rail BR livery HST, which sits next to the Junior, and then East Midlands, next one in line. There we go. So it just squeezes the cover at the back. But just pushing them forward a little bit to give the trains a bit more space. Not for them. That's these Midlands. And just go to the other HST, which is the East Coast. And I'll put away all the coaches as well. Thank you. Okay. That's pretty cool. Okay, there's my voice. I hope you guys enjoyed that little video. It was close to an hour in the end, but I'm hoping to feel better for the weekend, because right now I feel quite lousy, but hopefully over the next several days I should feel better. If I don't, there will be no video for you on Saturday. I've got some things to organise over this coming weekend, and got a bunch of things to organise with all of that lot on the windowsill. All of those just there, lined up. And the Pride thing is just my support for the Pride event stuff, for people attracted to the same genders. I'm very much up for supporting people like that, which is very much my thing. I mean, it could be partially because I am open to that sort of thing myself, but it's aimed at others too. Anyway, I hope you guys enjoy the rest of your evening, and I'll catch you guys again soon for another video, which will be on Thursday now. So, have a great evening, and peace out.